I'm ready.
Hey, this is Paul Stanley, and you are listening to Pod of Thunder.
Welcome to Pod of Thunder, the recognized symbol of excellence in KISS podcasting. It's your buddy Andy, America's little brother, and I am joined by Gnarly Nick, the Garlic Dragon, and the breakout star of the podcast medium himself. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Chris L. You guys okay over there? Both of you seem like you're a little bit under the weather. You're coughing.
It's cold as hell.
It's cold as
Nick's
hell.
Nick's alarm didn't go off. He overslept.
Yeah, Nick fell asleep.
Ran out of the house on it's in the teens out there, wouldn't you say?
No, it wasn't that bad compared to like yesterday.
There's only one way to find out.
It's pretty chilly. I don't know. But
it's 22.
Yeah.
It's 22 right now.
No, but still, you ran out of the house without your Quebec skull cap on.
Chris made a prediction that you were going to be wearing that. Yeah. Unfortunately, it didn't happen.
You know,
when you're running out of the house, you don't dress as fancy as you normally would.
You did have your hood on, though, so that counts.
Oh, yeah.
Keep your head warm.
But, you know, spring and summer for Nick, it's basketball shorts weather.
Mm-hmm. Baseball hat.
Colder temperatures. We expect. We demand the Quebec skull cap.
I almost didn't change the Detroit Red Wings Zubas that I was wearing.
Why did you?
I don't know. Because they're thin.
Oh, so it's more of a temperature thing, not a not a humiliation thing.
Well, both.
Were you powerlifting before you fell asleep earlier?
I took a power nap.
Oh, okay. That's why you put them on.
Yeah.
Got it. All right. Well, we're here, guys. And Nick, there's one episode left, so you have to wear your Quebec hat next week. Or else.
I didn't know that was a thing.
It's a thing.
I'll do it.
What do you mean you didn't know it was a thing?
It's been a thing for a number of years since the show started.
Didn't you buy that on the streets of Quebec?
I did. Quebec City.
It's legit.
Made, if you look at the label inside, made in Quebec.
Yeah, on that note, I might have to, hopefully I can find it, but I have a winter wool cap with a Detroit patch on it that I purchased at a gas station in the inner city of Detroit when I should have been figuring out a way to get the hell out of there.
Yeah. I'm like,
let me get one of those hats while I'm at it.
What are you doing shopping? You're supposed to run
Who
for your
knows?
Life.
Was behind the bulletproof glass.
Understandably.
Did we ever discuss the hat that you to this day regret not buying at a gas station?
I don't know.
We discussed it?
Yeah, we ever brought it up on
here? I don't know if we've discussed it on here. The cowgirl hat?
Yeah. I mean, Chris laments this fact.
Well, where were we again?
We were on our way to Ohio. We were in Ohio or right on the border of Indiana and Ohio.
Yeah.
And stopped at a random gas station, and they had night helmet.
Yeah.
Night, like
awesome.
Iron night
Spartan
masks.
Spartan helmet. Yeah.
I think we should have bought those.
And
that could be fun.
And they had a hat. What was it? Like pink and brown.
And like one of those sequins on it, I believe.
Yeah.
Just said cowgirl on it.
You may have seen the reverse cowgirl meme that Nick made. That was the actual hat in question.
That's nice for Dave.
Huge mistake not buying that.
Cowgirl.
And like Chris said, he could have just worn it backwards and made his statement.
Exactly right. I don't know what I was thinking.
Yeah. Oh, well.
What missed opportunity. Yeah. Story of my life.
Maybe if we take a road trip in the next week, we'll stop and pick up some trucker hats. Cowgirl trucker hats.
heard the there's a rumor on the street that the reason we made that road trip might finally be coming to fruition, but yeah, that's all we can say about it at this moment.
We'll see. Yeah. You know what was interesting? When we were in that gas station, I was admiring the knights' helmets, and there was one that was a Roman soldier helmet. This truck driver walked up to me.
Oh, boy.
He told me I could buy that one for $100, or he would give me one for $25 in the parking lot. So.
Is this one of those that have the showers?
Yep.
I never, you know, obviously.
Play a game of hide the helmet.
I've never seen what a shower
you don't
area
see
looks
it.
Like in a gas
you don't
station.
Don't see
have
it.
You done it, Chris, when you were touring with your band?
Have I done it?
Yeah.
I think once or twice it was one of those like just kind of like a small individual like rooms that you get, but there are other truck stops where there's like a fucking lounge area outside of the shower facility.
What are you supposed
section,
to be doing in there?
Waiting for other truck drivers to show up so you can fuck each other.
Oh, okay. Yeah. That makes sense.
It's like you poke your head in there, no pun intended, and you see like three guys sitting around. It's like, okay, I'm not taking another step in this direction.
Don't
getting
they,
the hell out of here.
Don't they have work to do? Don't they have trucks to drive?
Yeah,
just lounging.
Know, if you're ahead of schedule.
I guess so.
Or if you just need a release. That's what you got to do.
I suppose.
There are no Asian spas in the immediate future.
Yeah, I guess I shouldn't knock it. I don't know the lifestyle. I don't know the struggle of a truck driver. I can't imagine.
The struggle is real, apparently.
I believe it.
I remember thinking when I was younger, I'd like to do that. Like when I was a little kid. Oh, yeah. That sounds like fun.
I still have fleeting thoughts that it might be cool to do that, but everything you hear about it is it's a nightmare. You don't get paid for shit. You're under incredible pressure to complete routes and like impossible times and just is not worth it. But
and doesn't it do pretty significant damage to your body over a long time? Just sitting for hours and hours and hours eating shit in gas stations and sitting. That's it. I don't know. And then lounging with other truck drivers. That's the only exercise
occasional,
you get.
The occasional Perkins waitress, if you're lucky.
Oh, there you go. Rhythmic slapping at the truck stop
exactly
shower
right.
lounge. Yeah. I don't know. That seems like a difficult life. So, hey, if anybody who listens, I don't know. I'm guessing someone does.
Yeah. You would think that truck drivers would be consuming podcasts.
I've just never heard from any. But, hey, if you're a truck driver, hats off to you. Cowgirl hats off to you. And hey,
they consume podcasts and other truckers' cocks. That's what they do. Alternating fashion.
Well, this
whatever gets you through.
This episode's almost over. You know what's next.
Well, speaking of trucks, here's one rumbling down the street.
It's so late. This guy's still out here.
Can you even drive a truck of this size down these residential streets? I mean, it's a holiday season. He's got a bigger vehicle.
Yeah, load it up.
Kind of along the lines of what we're talking about the other day, I was on my way to work and went down a road where it's not part of the truck route.
Yeah.
There was a truck in front of me, and he was slowing down. I'm like, no, he's not going to go. Yep, he is. He turned down that road.
Yeah.
So I'm and it's just a two lane thing. I'm just trailing them, and then I see an oncoming traffic, a sheriff's vehicle stopped. I stopped because I'm like, this guy's gonna make a U-turn and go get him. So I did.
And that's what happened.
I stopped in the middle of the street and then yep, he put on his lights and went and got him.
Wow.
So I felt a little bit like
it was like an assist.
Like I didn't an assist, but I didn't. And then I kind of felt like I didn't need to do that, you know. But
like citizen's arrest.
Almost, but he would have gotten them anyway, but I don't know. I don't think I would have been a significant enough buffer, you know.
Nick's the John Stockton of truck driver infractions, assisting the sheriff. Incredible. Incredible stuff.
It was Gretzky-esque.
Wow. Yeah, Nick could have done it himself, but he gets more joy of helping the
sheriff.
It's
a point either way.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, so there's a package. Mm. Oh, my God. Another thing. Can you imagine? This guy's still out. Right now, it's 10:08 p.m. as we're recording
Goodness
this.
Me.
Can you imagine still being out delivering mail? The holiday season has to be hell for the, what is it, UPS or FedEx, who does Amazon Prime? Or is it the post office? I don't even know. Whoever it is, yeah, but oh my God.
Whoever the lowest bidder is.
Yeah,
that's how that business works.
It is, but my God. Around this time of year, that's got to be nonstop.
Hey, man. You got to work.
No, you got to work. I'm not knocking that. I'm just saying.
If you don't want that increased workload, don't take a job in that industry this time of year.
Yeah. I guess comes with the territory. But, Nick, we need you.
Ooh.
I know you're tired. I know the alarm didn't go off. I know.
I didn't even set it.
Mm. But we need you to walk over there,
mm.
pick up that box,
mm.
and you need to tell us.
Who's this from?
So do it.
Gee, I wonder what he's going to say.
It's the Double Platinum Club. Thank you.
It is?
Gee, what a shocker. I'm not gonna do it. I'm telling you, this is a legitimate mental block for me. I know it's coming, but I just cannot get the acronyms right.
That's all right. Maybe next time.
Oh, there's only gonna be one next time.
We'll try it again.
I need a teleprompter. Here's what I need. Need an iPad on this mic stand that's feeding me lyrics.
We can do that.
Like one of those shitty, unrehearsed cover bands we talked about last week.
That's so unacceptable.
It really is.
I'm sorry. I don't care who you are, whether it's a shitty cover band or one of the biggest bands in the world. If you have to read your lyrics off a teleprompter, you're not rock and roll anymore. I'm sorry.
I don't know how many people rely on them, but isn't it pretty much understood that everybody's got it?
All the big bands have it, it's just there
whether they need it or not.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's almost part of the live rig these days.
First band I ever heard of that there was like a controversy about this was Guns N' Roses, like years ago.
Mm.
That was the first band I'd ever heard of where they had the teleprompters.
That's horse shit.
Yeah.
This was when they were together, the first stretch. So.
Wow.
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's a hot button issue for a lot of people, but make no mistake.
what a hot button issue.
No, it is. Like, you bring it up and you got people who either don't care. It's kind of like the piped in vocals.
Yeah.
But make no mistake, if you're some shit cover band.
Yeah.
Crammed in the corner of a sports bar and waiting for the West Coast games to be over with so you can perform your lousy set, and you do so and you're staring at a fucking iPad on your mic stand, go home immediately.
Yeah.
You shouldn't be out in public.
Right.
And if you don't have time to rehearse or learn the material because of your job or your kids, stop doing it.
You're done.
Quit immediately.
Either find time or quit.
Yes.
Or just make the lyrics up. It's fine.
Or do what Vince Neil does. Point the mic at the crowd.
While you chug a beer.
Because guess what? You're actually engaging the crowd when you do that.
Yeah. When you're reading your iPad.
Better yet, though, just quit. Just go home.
Yeah.
And don't burden the public with your crap.
Exactly.
Speaking of which,
Nick, what do you got?
Nick, what do we got?
Burdening the public with crap.
I have got a replacement. It's the first replacement item that I've ever received.
What'd you send in for a refund?
Well,
was it recalled?
Well, yeah, I had to. We got it.
Are
we
you
got,
making
we,
it up?
No,
on
no.
The
no
spot?
We got a card.
What are they sending us ground beef now?
Oh, we got
the salmonella recall.
No,
I
mean,
ate
we,
some of that.
We
today.
Got the recall card in the mail a few weeks ago. Sent in the item, and they did a little
exchange,
a little electrical modification. Just to make sure
firmware update or something?
Well,
or more than that?
No, it wasn't like that.
Soldering?
Yeah. jacketing on the
okay.
the power cable.
There you go.
It was faulty.
Got it.
Ejaculating on the power cable?
Well, wow.
That was a faulty decision.
Yeah. I'd send it back if that happened.
Okay. So this, we've had the modifications before, but this is
this
a
is
replacement.
A, yeah, recall,
okay.
replacement
recall.
Kind of a thing. And it's for the, it's actually on the very first, the very first item, unique item that we had ever had on this podcast, the first exclusive Kiss item. I don't know if any of you, I don't know if you guys remember, I won't say.
Let's go back.
I won't say until you guys have a fair shot to try to recall.
Was this episode one?
No.
Or no, we didn't do that right away. I don't remember how that started.
Yeah, and then we didn't have exclusive merchandise right away either.
Oh, okay, because we had actual...
actual Kiss merchandise that...
That's not
that was
say,
available, yeah.
How you say...
Andy's got his hands full over there.
That's what it is, okay. Non-prototype.
What are the are those shuffling papers in the background? I never really noticed that before.
He's opening a paper bag.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and he's in the airport?
Yeah, he's about to get on his flight back to his home country. After they've...
And he thought he failed.
Yeah, basically.
Turns out Jay Leno came through for him.
Jay Leno with a babe on his arm.
Hey, don't take it so hard. Look in the bag.
Yeah. One arm in a sling, the other around a babe. What a way to end
this
a movie.
Babe cares not about about whatever, extremely valuable item he just handed him in a paper bag.
Yeah, she also doesn't seem to care that he's bloodied and bruised. And
no.
She probably likes it that way.
Maybe so. All right, so... What is it?
No guesses?
I don't remember that far
back.
I want to just say it's Darth Simmons, but that's not.
Oh, come on.
I know that was way later.
Yeah. No, it's the Fits Like a Glove electric butter knife.
Oh, my God. Okay, the hot knife through butter.
Yes.
Yes.
This is the, if memory serves, and I believe it does, the very first exclusive Kiss item that we ever acquired.
That was it, huh?
That was it.
First year?
Yeah, first year, I'm thinking for sure.
For sure?
Yeah.
Okay. I can't remember anything. I bet if we listened to, episode 40 of Pod of I would have zero recollection of anything that ever happened.
Yeah, probably.
Like 40 to 140.
Well, that's like...
No memory.
That's like asking one of the old guys at the local McDonald's, what did you guys talk about when you had your coffee on, 400 Tuesdays ago.
Right.
What was the conversation? They're not. They don't know.
Yeah. Good point.
How are they supposed to remember that?
That's basically who we are and what we're doing. The old guys getting the 99-cent coffee.
The regulars who don't even go to the register. They get the attention. Like there's a line, and then they get the attention.
Oh, on the side.
On the side of the employee. Hey, I'm here. Gonna go.
Give me the coffee.
Yeah.
VIP there, section.
Yeah, there's some sort of strange I don't know. They some sort of plateau of familiarity that they've reached.
I'd like to reach that at some point in my life. Anywhere.
What kind of place would you like to be a regular at, though? Are we talking just like a little restaurant?
A restaurant, I think.
Donut
truck
place?
Stop, shower area.
Hey, buddy. There he is, America's little brother.
You can skip the line to...
I don't have to wait for those three guys. Oh, man. All right, so the electric butter knife.
The community center in Whiting, Indiana, where the old naked guys walk around freely.
Or any gym where old guys are members. So
what is
that?
That's
I think we've discussed that.
We might have.
That might have been episode 40 of
Yeah,
exactly.
That's the one where I was a basketball team about 12 years old. Naked guy, really old, really naked, walking around in front of all of us, holding his towel in his hand instead of wearing it around his waist.
It's a bizarre psychological phenomenon.
And I believe that's the same locker room where I was told by a friend of mine
to get on your knees
that he was there and that there was a guy naked shaving at one of the sinks with the mirror.
I've seen that in the last 5 years when I still had a membership to the gym.
I don't
gym.
Get why you don't.
You walk by and it's not even like in their own space. They're right, out there on the end.
They're not standing in front of your locker getting changed. No. You're just, I'm naked. I'm going to go do the rounds.
Who has time? Who shaves at the gym? Don't you have a sink at home? Do you not have a mirror that you own? Like, I feel like, what are the thing? This is what goes through the guy's head. How many things can I do that'll take as much time as possible where I could stand naked in front of everyone? Okay,
well,
I could shower.
Exhibitionism might be a legitimate factor there.
Yeah.
Who knows? I don't even want to know what's up with that.
I think that would legitimately be a sexual assault today if you walked around naked in front of children. But back then
it was shocking to me.
Yeah.
This guy didn't seem like the lights may have even not been all the way on. There was nobody home, but it was shocking. It was one of those things where like you hear about, and obviously it wasn't like a real violation.
Right, he didn't.
But you feel like overwhelmed and almost like you know people like this is going to be a little bit maybe too serious, but you know you hear about people who something will happen to them sexually, like an assault, and they'll say, I felt guilty afterwards.
Sure.
Like it was my fault.
I've heard that.
And hearing that, it sounds like that doesn't make any sense.
Mm-hmm.
But then I remember there was like a shock.
Mm-hmm.
And then, there was like this weird guilty feeling for some reason.
Wow. I wonder where that comes from.
I don't know. But like this old exhibitionist guy.
he assaulted your senses.
He did. He did. And then, thank God nothing. That was the worst that ever happened to me. But I can kind of sort of see how, people get those feelings if something traumatic happens, even though it was mostly just a gross out kind of a moment instead of like a physical assault.
Yeah.
But still, unwanted and clearly over the line.
Yeah, exactly. So speaking of shaving, can we take the hot knife through butter, electric...
And shave?
Butter knife and shave? I
don't know that that's a good idea.
Have you ever seen a naked man at the gym cutting his butter with the electric butter knife? Just for later.
Buttering his rolls.
Yeah, this is for Thanksgiving. Freeze them for next year.
No, creeps. Thankfully, this is something that you're supposed to use fully clothed. It says so on the box.
That's good. That makes sense. You should probably specify that, especially with Kiss fans. Now, this was for butter though exclusively. It heats up, so you can easily slice through
butter. When you got a cold stick.
Yeah. Cold stick. Who wants to say it?
Nobody.
All right.
Leave it laying there. It's crawling out the door.
Yeah, there it goes.
It's
gray pubes and all. There it goes out the door.
Really long too. Like the hairs are like fishing line thickness too. That's what it does. Mm-hmm. When you don't want to wait for the butter to come to room temperature, so it's a spreadable.
It makes sense.
Sort of temperature.
Because
softness.
There's that whole problem when you try to microwave it. It's frozen.
Oh, yeah,
it's a melted mess 1 second later. You can't get it just right.
And you got to do like the tiniest little scrapes to try to, you know.
Yeah. What a pile
of
shit.
So this takes care of that problem.
Love it. Okay. So what needed to happen? Why is it fixed?
It was what we talked about before. It was they had to fix the little power cable. The insulation and all that. It wasn't up to modern code.
Gotcha. Okay.
This thing is old. So, I'm going to turn
Speaking of old and not up to code, the random song generator, which, by the way, it will pretty much be, for all intents and purposes, picking two songs tonight, because whichever one it picks tonight, we know what will be coming out next week. So do we even need it next week?
I don't know. What if it, I think it, what if it does something else?
What's the for? It's it, would it be just a formality at that point?
I don't know. Nick did the data dump. We got list.
I mean, it's thrown curveballs before, so who knows?
That's all we need.
Who knows?
That's all we need.
I'm going to go turn it on against my better judgment.
Turn it on. Wait, you're going to turn on what, the butter knife or the generator?
Well, I
got to
plug in. I got to turn on the generator so I can plug in the butter knife.
Oh, okay. I gotcha. That makes sense to me. Hell yeah. How about that?
My.
Song kicks ass. All right. That thing is up and running. Not up to code.
Look at those Christmas lights.
Yeah, they flickered off and on a little bit.
Yeah, well, they used the gun. The light gun.
The Lightkeeper Pro.
And it fixed it.
That piece of shit that barely ever works. $20, my ass.
No way that was even possible going to work.
On the box at the store, on the display for the Lightkeeper Pro Christmas light repair gun, it says, it practically pays for itself.
That's a lie. Flat out lie.
I've had success.
But have you had only success? I mean,
no.
I've had a couple successes and a lot of failures.
I've had probably more success than not.
Really?
With it, yeah.
All right.
Yeah, but there are some knots in there.
There are some knots.
It's like, oh, I got this refrigerator and 25 days out of the month it works, and the other five it's completely dead. But
spoils my
food. Know,
hey,
I'm just living with it. No, that's not how it works.
Yeah.
The thing should be smashed in the driveway like an ELO 8 track. It's the fate it deserves.
Yep.
So yeah, tonight we, unless there's any bullshit in the future, which is always a possibility, we will learn the final two songs. And of course we will also learn the winner of the last song elimination challenge.
Holy shit.
All the suspense is going away tonight.
Tonight. Is there a definite winner for the song elimination challenge? Are there people that have the last two songs?
Yes, sir.
There are. Okay.
All the songs were in play from the initial deadline, so it's been quite exciting. And
yeah,
tonight, or in a matter of seconds, all will be revealed.
All right. So how does this butter knife interact?
I'm just going to plug it in, and I got some toast while you guys are talking.
Oh, cool.
Did a little toast here.
I
and
can go for some toast.
I'm gonna butter some toast.
See, that's the other thing, is when you got a cold pat of butter and you try to put it on toast, you just like smash the
it's
bread apart.
Or if you got like a really soft piece of bread, it just rips it.
Yeah, it's just cold and or frozen butter is not ideal.
No. If you're going to pass out a banquet bread basket, the least you can do is room temperature up that butter beforehand.
Yeah.
Because if you're going to...
if the only thing missing from your herb bread rolls is some butter, then...
You can't give out cold
butter. You got to think ahead.
Plus, when you get butter at room temperature, that's when you have your visible moisture on the stick.
Yeah.
Which is always a desirable condition.
Actually, there's...
Ask anyone. I'll tell you.
I actually have a clip of Nick trying to put some frozen butter on his soft herb bread.
Bullshit!
That's how you feel.
That's it. That should be every reaction to when you go to a restaurant and the butter's too cold. You yell bullshit and throw it on the floor.
That should be perfectly acceptable.
It should be.
And there should be just apologies and okay.
Free meal.
We'll warm it up for you.
Free pie to go.
Get out the whipped butter at least.
Yeah. Assholes. All right, so plug it in, man. You ready?
Yeah, man.
There it is.
I'm going to butter this toast. It's going to be great. Butter it here.
What the hell?
Look at that. So good.
Oh,
Jesus. I nearly lost a hand there.
Look out.
Damn. There's residual explosions coming off that thing. Good thing they got it up to code.
Yeah,
working
right?
Great.
Apparently that didn't help.
You should probably notify someone.
Still faulty.
Jeez.
Better check the lawsuit at this point.
Check the mailbox for more recall cards.
It's like you cite the traumatic experience on par with what Nick experienced in that community center. What? Locker room
area.
Jesus.
Yeah.
It was the concession stand.
Yeah. Exactly. Hole in the bottom of the popcorn tub track.
That old gag.
Yep.
Nope. All right. So, we don't know what it is.
Bringing down the house. Anyway.
We know.
Oh, we do know.
I mean, there's always some sort of significant reaction.
Did it print the name on the toast?
Yeah, it was one of, you know.
It's embedded in the butter, Pat.
You know, my wife claims that she saw somewhere there is some kind of device that you can buy that toasts your bread and gives you the temperature outside.
I've seen
in
it.
The toast.
I think it's a sharper image thing or something. One of those catalogs.
Gives you the temperature of what? The toast?
Outside. Like, your local temperature.
Who cares? Why would you need to know that?
Toasted on the bread.
Like today, it's 52 degrees.
Oh, toasted on the bread.
Yeah, so like you put your toast
so
in
So what,
the
you
morning.
Got like, is it like a Wi-Fi
you must have
toaster
to.
Or something?
Yeah, yeah.
Gathers the info and, yeah.
That's one of those things where it's like, oh, that's cool. And then you think about it and you're like, I don't need that at all.
Yeah. What a stupid thing to put on your toast.
I mean, of all the things you could think to have a random daily thing, what? It shouldn't be the temperature. There's other places to get that.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So can you read the toast?
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. The butter, thankfully, kind of, it's almost like an invisible ink kind of a thing.
Oh, well,
the
listen
butter
to
helps
me.
It make
listen,
it more
okay.
legible.
Listen to me. All right. There are two songs left. One of them has a one-word title. The other one has a four-word title. You should, even if it's illegible, you should be able to tell which one is which. Oh, so
let's give it a shot.
Let's quit the game playing and get down to business. Here it comes.
This one comes off.
Music from the Elder.
It's called
Odyssey.
Bing bong. That means one person picked the last song, and that was Mr. Jack Broad.
Wow.
For What's On Your Mind. So, something to look forward to next week and beyond. But for now, we have Odyssey.
We have Odyssey. So, here we go, guys. Paul Stanley said, "It was a good song when I heard Tony Powers, the guy who wrote it, sing it because it was unique, and it was very much suited to him. Me singing it was just tragic."
Oh, my.
Jeez. Okay. Who's Tony Powers? Who is this individual? Do we know?
No, I don't.
I keep thinking Tony Banks, right? No.
No, not him.
Who's Tony Banks?
It's Genesis.
Tony Little?
Tony Little, maybe.
I don't know. Here's another.
But wait, so he's the sole songwriter of this?
I guess so. I don't know about this one, but that's what it sounds like.
Let me, as you're reading, I'll look it up here.
Bob Ezrin said,
"Oh, jeez.
Tony Powers wrote Odyssey outright."
Well, there's your answer.
Straight away.
Yeah. I'd write that song straight away.
Tony Powers wrote Odyssey outright. That is weird. I fully understand the song, but I completely reject Kiss doing it now that I look back on it.
Yeah, this is kind of stunning to me. Is there another, like, besides an outright cover, like Is That You or some of the other cover versions,
Is That You, yeah.
Is there any song just entirely written by someone else that they included on an album?
Well, aside,
also strange that they included in this concept album.
Yeah.
How does it just happen to fit in with what was going on? Assuming it it did, but
I don't know where we were coming from on that. Well, we tried.
Well, there you go. We tried.
Oh, this is boy, what a sell job for this song.
Is That You is the only one I could think of that's not like a well known, you know, like Any Way You Want It or something like
right.
that. Is That You is the only other one I could think of, unless you go into the solo albums and you've got what Russ Ballard doing a
right.
groove.
But I mean, this isn't even technically a cover. It's just they did somebody else's song.
Did you find out who he is?
No, I didn't. Should I have done that?
Nobody cares.
Should I have been doing this?
I don't know.
But nobody cares.
I have to tell you guys something that I forgot.
Uh-oh.
And if we are going to be completists, like we're acting like we are.
Yeah.
If you remember, I don't know how long ago this was, but a long time ago, we drew the random song, Fanfare. And I don't know if it was on the show or we deleted it and started over, but we said, fuck that, we're not doing an 80-second instrumental thing as its own episode. But I think to be completist, we should do Fanfare into Odyssey.
Okay.
How it is on the album?
No, but if we leave Fanfare totally out, someone's going to say we dodged a track that's its own thing. So
whatever.
I think it's only fair.
It's 80 seconds.
I have no idea. Like he's a songwriter, you know, artist. And
nobody cares.
But he's got some acting credits.
Oh, God.
So it's just some dude. Okay.
Which include... The Equalizer TV series, the NYPD Blue, King of Queens, which everybody was on, apparently.
Huh.
Cadillac Man.
Never heard of that one.
Robin Williams, right?
Okay.
Catch Me If You Can, which Andy and I saw in the theater together.
Oh,
apparently he's in Goodfellas.
No kidding.
Yeah. No idea what he plays in any of these movies.
See the truck driver who gets his truck stolen. And
comes running,
delivers a great piece of ad-lib dialogue by the payphone.
Don't know, but let's just say, yeah.
That's him, huh?
Hey, right. You got a phone?
All right.
Believe that shit?
Man.
Quick Bob Ezrin note about Fanfare. This is just from the middle of the paragraph. I'm not going to read the whole thing, but to achieve an otherworldly effect, we decided to use medieval instruments such as the racket and crumhorn.
Oh, great. So this is a...
Jesus.
We're getting into Blackmore's Night type of territory here.
Terrific.
Let's just...
All we need.
You guys ready to do this? Get it over with?
Yeah. Yes.
Let's rip off the Band-Aid here. Fanfare first. Fanfare's track one on The Elder. Odyssey's three, but that's just the way it's got to go.
What was second?
Just a Boy.
Oh, okay.
Wow.
That is otherworldly.
I feel like I'm in another
world?
Another locale, at least.
Okay.
So imagine you're listening to this album for the first time.
I've been...
you're like, what?
Yeah, this
is... this a mistake?
Yeah, did they print the wrong label on this?
I feel like I'm at least in a different time zone.
Wow.
I don't care what kind of drugs or what other sort of stuff is on your mind.
Jesus.
This makes no sense. Join us for an evening of feasting and festivities.
Now you got the Tibetan monks.
Yeah.
Is this still part of Fanfare?
Yeah, there it is.
Wow.
So that was Fanfare. I play that song every time before I release my Falcon.
Speaking of which,
I found on, I think I showed this to Andy, and I think it was our friend Rich.
Mm-hmm.
Rich
the plug kicker?
Rich, who's famous for, for all kinds of mishaps when he's around Chris Jericho.
Yeah.
And I showed them, can you believe it? On Amazon, you can buy falconry gloves.
Hell yeah. That's great.
Why wouldn't you be able
That's
to?
That's true. It's not an item you ever, it's one of those things where you think you gotta
know someone.
You have to know someone, or you have to go to the right place to acquire such things.
You have to go to a previous falconer who's retiring.
Like it's not something you can do an inebriated Amazon purchase.
Well, there are some things that like you can only get through police. What's the word I'm looking for? But like an
authorized dealer,
right. A place that's you have to be like you proved that you're a cop, and you
sure.
can get like a police outfitter, so to speak.
Yeah.
So my brother used to be a cop. He retired recently, but I remember when he. Was first on the force. He got these leather gloves that you could only get at this cop store, and had like this raised panel on all the knuckles, and it was filled with powdered lead.
Ooh, wow!
I mean, you could smash your hand partially through a brick wall with those things.
Wow!
Crazy stuff.
Never heard
Who
of that.
Knows what other merchandise is available? Puts the DPC to shame. But, so that kind of reminds me of, you have to have that type of authorization. So a falconer glove just has the platform somewhere on it.
Well, and
it's like
be
a goalie blocker, so to speak.
Yeah. Can you buy a falcon helmet?
And it goes what? I don't know about
the
maybe,
thing that
maybe.
Blinds them or whatever so they don't fly away.
The little mask.
The little mask. And what's the thing that the guy swings around to make him do tricks?
That's a, I don't know.
His dick.
I missed that at medieval times.
That's the after midnight show.
Okay.
The naked guy comes up. The glove, that glove that goes up past his elbow, and
naked,
that's it.
Naked guy helicopter swap.
You have to look
leather
up
glove.
The falconer glove. But yeah, okay. So fanfare.
Yeah.
Crap. Stupid.
You know.
Seriously, you're putting the album on for the first time. This is back in what 1981.
Yeah.
Wasn't really a ton of internet, or well, there wasn't any internet really, but things weren't just leaked and spoilers weren't everywhere. You didn't know what to expect when this came out, right?
Right.
You put this on, you're just like, what the fuck is this?
Yeah.
And by the titles of the song, it's not, aside from like Just a Boy, mm-hmm. it's not really clear probably at first. Like when you if you turn the record over and look at the songs, you probably aren't 100% sure that this is what it's going to sound like immediately.
Yeah.
No, not at all.
Like Just a Boy, you kind of probably make a face when you see that title.
Yeah.
But everything else could work.
Yeah.
In a rock album.
The titles. Yeah.
I
sure.
think unless I'm forgetting something, but. Even like
Mr. Blackwell, I don't know,
man. That was maybe. A pretty sweet song, though. That's our mom's, Andy and I's mom. That's one of her favorites.
Really?
Yeah, because of listening to this podcast, that's one of her favorite Kiss songs.
Wow. Okay.
I don't know. I have to break it to her one of these days before the upcoming end of the road tour. They're probably not going to play it.
Yeah, I don't think they would play that ever.
That and I think Domino is one of her favorites.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
It's very interesting.
Can't play that one around
interesting
the kids.
And weird. But, all right, so what do we got now? We got the song at hand, Odyssey.
Yep.
That's it. You guys ready for this?
Yeah.
I guess so.
Let's get it on.
Speaking of Goodfellas, I'm expecting the outro of Layla to be kicking in any time now with these piano chords.
Right.
From a far off galaxy, I hear you calling me. We are on an odyssey through the realms of time and space in that enchanted place.
Wow. I think that delivery of that last line. Oh my God.
This is almost like Game of Thrones-esque, right?
I looked over
from that era.
I looked over at Chris during that first section, and I thought he was flatlining.
Just, I was trying to figure out what was going on.
I put a mirror under his nose just to see if he was still with us.
Yeah. Perplexing.
Yeah.
I don't know what to... I mean, it's almost to the point where piling on the elder has become cliche and like the...
Well, it's come...
The reflex action, and it's almost like it's expected, so therefore it's a contrived criticism, but this is the first I'm hearing this. Throughout the podcast was the first I was hearing any of it, really, except for World Without Heroes and I, and it's just... You just sit there in disbelief. It's like, what were they thinking? Am I wrong? I mean,
I think criticizing the elder has kind of become new again, because we talked about this before. I don't remember which song it was on which episode, but it was an elder song where it's almost sort of a perverse sort of pleasure that I think people get when they overly praise the elder.
Yeah, it's like,
because
again,
it's obviously just,
you're intentionally going against the crowd to have a hot take. It's like you're forcing yourself to like it.
Yeah.
And eventually you actually believe that you like it. I don't know.
It's definitely perverse.
I don't understand. I cannot relate to anyone in any way who finds quality in what we're listening to.
What is it? Perverse Suffering is the song that I'm trying to think of.
Yes.
No, is that Cannibal Corpse?
That's Cannibal Corpse, yeah. Yep. That's the one.
You and I come face to face. Once upon a
I mean, I know they say that like Bob Ezrin had a cocaine problem and stuff, but did Paul Stanley have a drug problem? Like, no, right? I mean, it's pretty highly agreed upon unanimously from what I've heard that no.
Yeah.
to think that this was a good idea, I don't know. I guess it's just weird, man, to be a fly on the wall during the not necessarily the recording of this album, but just the decision making discussions.
Right. And also, we've talked about this before, but can you imagine being Eric Carr? I mean, hey, you're in Kiss now, and this is what you're playing?
Yeah.
It's the worst. That would suck so bad.
Yeah.
Even though I'm sure he could be doing worse for himself, but when you're a hard rock drummer, and then you're in Kiss, and then, hey guys, here's the new material. What?
Luminous at night, on beams of neon light, you and I in winged flight.
Oh. He just said, you and I in winged flight.
Goodness me.
Ghastly stuff.
I mean, I know
this is like off-Broadway, like a bad... You know, theater production.
Yeah, terrible. I mean, it's surprising.
It's like a middle school theater production. You know?
It's surprising that they haven't, I mean, maybe somebody somewhere has done it, but that there hasn't been a musical.
The Elder?
I mean, yeah, because we talked about
again,
that.
It would be a theater production that would be a disaster.
Well, we
nobody would see it.
We talked about Mr. Blackwell and how it had that vibe of, like, the villain, you know, the, you know, people strutting around him saying, you know, you're whatever the words were, you're a terrible guy, Mr. Blackwell.
Yeah. Well, think of the combination.
You really are a heel.
The combination of balls and stupidity that it took to release this, multiply that by 10, and that's what you would need to release a musical based on this album.
Yeah, but as ridiculous as this is as a Kiss album, it would not be ridiculous as a like a Broadway-style musical.
Yeah, put who's that guy? Who's the Hamilton guy? Put him on the case.
Lin-Manuel Miranda.
He's at the point where whatever that guy puts out will be consumed in mass quantities. He could take a shit on stage like Gigi Allen. He'd be a fucking, people would be lining up to see whatever he puts out.
A Gigi Allen musical.
Yeah, exactly. he's achieved that level that no matter what he does, people will just reflexively consume it regardless of the quantity or the quality. So he's the guy who needs to do this.
As we cross the starry sea, powered by what we see.
What?
Now and then.
This is so stupid.
You say powered by what we see?
I think
and
so.
What are you seeing on the starry sea?
Yeah.
I've been on the Kiss cruise with the starry sea. You see nothing out there when you're in the middle of the sea.
You weren't powered by it?
What, are you looking up at the stars or what? I mean, that's the only thing I can think of. But what is this? What,
I don't know. What's this voice,
what is it,
too?
Yeah, and yeah, what does it have?
Powered by.
Terrible.
Don't answer this question, because, again, I don't care what the answer is, but... What does this have to do with the whole story? A voyage at sea? What is this?
It's such
Now is dare I ask if there's a connection to the Greek literature, the Odyssey? Are they trying to make some kind of connection there with the
It was either
being drawn in by the sirens or whatever the fuck they were.
I mean the
I don't care.
Demos for this album that didn't make it consisted of, but were not exclusively restricted to the Iliad.
Dante's Inferno.
I don't know. I can't.
I fucked my mother.
The Library of Alexandria.
Beowulf.
Yeah.
Such a shit.
Yeah, Don Quixote.
And a song called simply Homer.
Aristotle and Plato.
Yes.
In the victory. What's upon not yet? All the ghosts of day.
And again, we go back to it wasn't the part of the rationale behind this album is they wanted to impress the critics who had hated everything they'd done up to this point.
Yeah.
What were they thinking? It's really only question you can ask about
it. It's
this.
A thing, like, you hear about it all the time. You hear Paul and Gene even say it, you know, like, yeah, we were really off base and it was a mistake and all that. But when you're listening to it, and it's not an album that you listen to all the time, it's like it's a profound thought to you. Like right now, it's a fresh new thought, even though you've heard it for years from a lot of different sources. But yeah, what Chris said, what were they thinking? It's a legitimate, fresh question to ponder.
It's one that's never really been answered, and I don't even think you can answer it.
It's got to be just a perfect storm of many things going on.
I mean, try and transport yourself to the actual moment when this was being recorded. Paul Stanley singing this into a mic in the studio. Ezrin, band members, other people in the organization in the control room observing this. And they're just like, yeah, we're gonna put this out.
Nodding
this
their heads.
Great. Yeah.
There it is.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's like the scene in Boogie Nights when
I was just gonna
when
say
Marky
that.
Mark is singing the "You Got the Touch" and they switch to John C. Reilly dancing in place,
and pointing,
and the engineer is sitting there just completely horrified at what's going on. He's like, "What the hell? What am I in the middle of here?"
I don't know. It doesn't matter.
Oh, it's just at this point, it's just whining into the microphone.
I mean, this is... it's like, it is like yawning.
He almost sounded like Pierre right there. In fact, back it up and put Pierre's vocal
and
double the vocal with Pierre. See if you can time it up.
It's always a fun challenge. All right.
Listen to it once through so you get the timing right, and then see if you can double it.
All right.
Countless times we've met, along the way.
All right.
Okay, right after he says met along the way, kick it in. This is going to be good. The classic doubling of the vocal, a la the Beatles. You're about to hear it for the first time.
This is going to be excellent.
This is podcasting history. It's about to unfold.
Countless times we've met, met along the way.
you were too early on that.
Yeah. Okay.
Try it again.
Yeah, one more try.
Yes.
It's deserved. Let's do it one more.
Countless times we've met, met along the way.
There it is, yes.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah. I don't know what's going on with this song. But I don't even know where we are with the lyrics. I'm trying to find it.
Who cares? Again, who cares? Don't bother.
But I'm surprised. I'm not saying we're smart at all.
We're not.
But the fact that we've identified much of this album as the genre that it should belong to is like Broadway musical, and I don't know that I'd heard that anywhere else. I've heard Genesis album,
sure,
bad Genesis album,
stuff
like that. Yeah. But like, you know, medieval music or whatever, but I've never heard it.
This song, more than any of the others I've heard off this album, is just screaming, just shitty theater.
Yeah.
It's almost like a middle school theater production where the parents are sitting there, like, you know, obligated to be supportive, but in the back of their minds are just like, nobody on that stage has any talent. This is just a mistake by everyone involved.
My kid included. You know,
right. If they're being honest, which few people are these days with regards to their kids,
yeah,
you're just sitting there like, okay, this is terrible.
Not even occurring to them that the material is not doing them any favors either.
It's a perfect storm.
It's like the
garbage.
It is. This is, I mean, this is honestly, like Andy said, Chris said it. I don't remember. I just woke up. That it's, you know, cliche to knock this album. But man, this is terrible. I mean, in the moment, listening to it as we are, there's no other prognosis at this point.
Well, and there's other people who've said throughout the course of this podcast that, well, you're listening to the songs out of order and out of context. Don't give me that.
That's like if you throw up and then have diarrhea. It doesn't matter what order.
Yeah, exactly.
Both terrible.
And then eat afterwards.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. It doesn't matter.
it's collectively, it's a bad experience no matter what the sequence.
Yeah, don't give me that bullshit. rationalization.
Yeah. You throw up, you have diarrhea, you stub your toe, you get a flat tire. It doesn't matter the order. That's this album.
Exactly.
Countless times we've
there's a bee in the house.
That's always bad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Any number of mishaps.
Bee. What song would the bee in the house be?
I don't know. The bee in the house, we'll say, is...
Mr. Blackwell. It's kind of...
Yeah. That's a wasp in the house.
Yeah, yeah.
Even more startling and panic, causing more panic.
What? A child in a sundress?
Looking at a rainy sky.
Yeah, that's what he said. I wish I had Chris's reaction. Yeah. Eyes bugged out of his head.
You know what the weird, you know what the creepiest thing about that lyric is? He didn't say a girl in a sundress.
No,
so it's implying that it's a boy wearing a fucking sundress.
And if you say a girl, she could be 18. So if you know.
Right.
So it could be less creepy. It could be an older person.
Yeah. But no, it's a child.
A child in a sundress.
They accepted this song from someone who's not even in the band. Why the fuck would they record this garbage?
That's a shocking little interlude that it went down. Everything about that, the way he's singing it.
Yeah.
It's, ooh.
That was yucky.
This is a new low.
This is an SNL skit about fucking bad theater.
Yeah.
Really, really terrible.
I need something to make me feel better. Is there any candy in that dish over there?
Absolutely no
candy. Oh, shit. Oh, boy.
And there's a bee right over there.
Okay, fine.
And your lights just went out. Your twinkle lights just went out outside.
Oh, no.
There's a place in a desert where an ocean once danced by.
Oh, once danced?
Okay, I don't think there can be any doubt that this is the worst cut on this album. This might have surpassed Boomerang for me already.
Yeah it's...
This is absolute shit. Wow.
It's terrible.
It to the second to last. Can you imagine if this is the last? What a way to fucking crawl out of this thing. Jesus, I had no idea this was this bad. If I'd have known about this song, I'd have rigged the system to make sure this wasn't this close to the end. This is terrible.
Yeah.
Brutal.
Silence weaving in and out of time.
I mean, every lyric is more offensively stupid than the previous.
You're right.
It's like it's similar to a message we had going on earlier, that there's an R. Kelly song in question, which I would imagine we'll be hopefully listening to together in the same room at some point.
Save it.
But it was the opposite. It was every line of this song is more outlandish than the previous.
Yeah.
But in this case, every line is more offensively dumb.
Wow. I can't believe we have to listen.
How much time is left in this?
About 12 minutes.
Way too long. 2:45.
Goodness,
you gotta be kidding me.
No.
Oh my god.
I'd rather fill in the blank.
Jesus.
Yeah. Mad lib that.
Rather be sounded right now.
That's this part of the storyline. He's been sedated. That's why he's singing this way.
Oh.
he's being. It's a sounding ritual that they sedated him somewhat.
This is bad.
Your notes in the music, searching for remembered rhyme.
See?
Even
every
more
line
searching
is,
for what?
Every line is more offensively stupid than the previous.
Searching for...
Something rhyme.
We are notes in the music, searching for remembered rhyme.
Dumb.
That's bad, man.
awful.
This is dog crap. So stupid.
That's another thing you could add to your list, finding it in your yard. That's part
not your dog.
That's part of the elder.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter when it happens. It's not good. Doesn't it's not desirable and it's not
not wanted
no matter what it what's before or after it.
Seem like Paul Stanley's almost joking.
Yes, I mean,
like he did this as, like you said, as some kind of skit about something. It's like, oh, do with this ridiculous character. Okay, that'll be funny.
All right, Andy, I'm gonna quiz you.
Mm.
What's the? All right, it was a guy who was in the Aquabats and had a solo album years ago, and he had a song title.
Oh, God.
And what was it? Something about a horse on a mountain with the mane,
jeez,
the mane blowing in the wind, and it was. It was, I'm sure, supposed to be funny,
yeah,
like done to the comedic effect,
right?
But that kind of line
would be in this.
Would be better,
yeah.
And I forgot exactly how the guy phrased it. It was a song title, but
I don't remember either.
Yeah, it's
was Digital Unicorn.
Digital
was the
Unicorn
album.
was
But I don't remember. I know what you're talking about, but I can't remember the exact thing either. But yeah, exactly. This seems like someone mocking this style and genre.
What is the style and genre? I'm trying.
I don't
the whole
know.
Time we've been listening, I've been trying to think of something to compare it to, and I'm having a hard time. It's unprecedented.
It is. It's, I don't know.
It's astonishing is the word that comes to mind. Yeah.
People like this.
No, they don't.
No?
No.
There are some people out there.
You don't actually.
Are they lying?
You don't actually like it. You like the fact that you're telling people you like it.
Yeah, that's actually spot on analysis. It's an explanation for a lot of people's opinions.
Us.
You're just, you're trying to be an outlier. You're not fooling anybody. It's not even yourself.
Your opinion is as self-indulgent as this song.
Yeah.
And we shall be each other's destiny.
Come on.
One another's odyssey.
See, and we're at the stage where Nick is actually getting angry.
So rare.
Which has happened about maybe a half dozen times in this podcast, but like when he barks out, come on. I mean, to push him to this level is quite a statement, quite a feat.
Well, the fact that also we keep bringing up how people say they like this.
Yeah.
That's the thing getting under my skin right now. you can't honestly say that.
It can't be possible,
no,
right?
No, it simply cannot be possible.
Once upon God, yet.
I love when a bee gets in the house. I don't know about you guys. I don't know what you guys are talking about.
Stubbed my toe.
Oh, it's awesome.
Turned different colors.
I actually,
what an experience.
I actually enjoy being sounded.
It's I don't know.
I don't know how you get through the day without it.
I caught literally every red light today.
It's awesome.
It was great.
It's the best.
How could, you know, you have, the thing about catching every red light when you're in a hurry is you have, from an outsider's perspective,
right,
if you're
right.
not, it's hard for you to really speak about it.
Right.
Like, you have to go through that experience and come out the other side.
That's what it is.
To really appreciate it. The beauty that's in there.
That makes sense. the best part of the song so far.
There is no best part
no,
of this
you're right.
so far.
Let's, I take it back.
Yeah, I'm going to have to disagree with you. The only compliment, and I don't even know if it's a compliment I can give to this, and I don't even know much about this, but I'm going to say it anyway. It seems the orchestral elements here seem to be well conducted.
I'm sure, yeah.
And I don't
yes,
know anything about that.
I actually
that.
Agree with that.
I don't know anything about the necessity of a conductor in that sort of, you know, I know they say they're wonderful conductors. I don't know much about that. To be honest,
yeah.
But I mean, it's well performed.
Yeah,
from
sure.
that standpoint,
it just shouldn't happen.
No, it. But it's just, yeah.
Yeah. Has anyone ever been like, oh yeah, we got the worst orchestra on our album? It's never that. It's always like part of the bragging
yeah.
rights is like the royal whatever
yes,
harmonic
yes.
something. Yeah.
It's yep. like a choir, you know, same thing. Like
right.
Even Great Expectations, it was with the Harlem Boys Choir.
Yeah.
yeah.
I don't
yeah.
know how good
right.
that is, but I don't know what well, I don't
Harlem
know what prestige they carry.
The Harlem Boys Choir is the Angus steak of musical ensembles. It's like you just throw in a sizzle word.
Yeah.
You know, get me a choir and it's the let's see. It's the Quebec Flair de Lis choir.
Yes.
I don't know, you know.
right.
It's now they're just some shitty choir that were available. We got them on here, but let's tack on some sizzle words and it'll sound pretty awesome, you know. what it's so ridiculous what's yeah. going on.
I'm going to look up and see. I'm not going to try that hard, but I'm just going to go to the Wikipedia page and see if there's anything like that.
You know, actually, on the Pot of Thunder theme song, if you listen closely, you can hear the Retard and Boys Room Choir singing.
That's it. Yep. Yep.
oh, goodness.
Do we have to finish it?
Pish, plit, play wise.
Yeah, I think it's fading out.
Yeah.
So it's not good.
Dear Christ. My God.
Okay, hilarious.
Yeah?
To me, the name of the orchestra credited at least on the Wikipedia page.
Give it.
Oh, man.
The American Symphony Orchestra.
That's made up.
That reminds me of a joke me and Andy were going to play on one of his friends one time. Yeah. We wrote a fake letter and we called it the place that it was coming from. Was we called it the National Association of America.
Exactly. Yeah.
It's the same. That would have been the choir of that organization.
Yeah.
The fraternal organization, you know,
that's
related to that. the American
totally made up.
And St. Robert's Choir.
Oh, okay. That's good.
Yeah.
That's just some guy named Bob singing.
Yeah, exactly.
Bob Ezrin.
Yeah.
All right, so
wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah, exactly. Saint Robert's Choir. Is there even a Saint Robert?
I don't know.
Yeah,
I feel
I'm sure
like there
is.
Probably is, but I couldn't tell you anything about him.
The patron saint of shitty choirs.
You wouldn't believe the miracles
yeah,
he performed
exactly.
with his shitty choir. All right, so
the banquet breadbasket singers. Caribbean Cove Choir.
Conducted by Herb Bread.
Yeah.
All right. I think we might only need one sound clip, but let's get through this quickly. And let's say that these votes count for both songs, Fanfare and Odyssey.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. Who wants to vote first? Hell or Hallelujah?
Oh, me.
Nick.
Horseshack enthusiasm over here. Come on now, yeah. Hell.
Oh.
What? Couldn't even think of the word after these mind-numbing lyrics I just intake.
I was hovering over the other clip. Didn't know.
That would have been interesting. Try to justify a Hallelujah for this song.
It's impossible.
Yeah. I hate it. Somebody out there will, trust me. Aside from, you know, whoever was playing the instruments, the orchestra and all that, you know, very well performed, very, you know, on whatever, mixed pretty well. I don't know what else to say, but absolutely terrible aside from that. Just mind-numbingly bad.
Yeah.
And I'm not even saying that in like a, well, if you like this genre of music, I don't know what genre of music this is. And really, I think it would lend itself to like a Broadway musical kind of a thing,
yeah.
Which I think 99% of anything I've seen is pretty awful. That whole genre, musically speaking,
yeah.
is not, it doesn't work for me at all.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty awful in my opinion. And it's so like anything I've seen of it is so formulaic and tired. And I'm sure there are productions out on the fringe that mix it up.
Sure.
But you know, like fairly recently we had all the parades on TV, the Thanksgiving and all that.
Yeah.
And it, you know, if you watch it on certain stations, you just see these Broadway performances and it's the same, like, You can so easily predict
everything terrible
about every single one of them.
And the cheesy dancing.
Yeah, and it's
the
just
jazz
tired
hands and the facial expressions and the costumes. All complete garbage.
Now, I don't want to offend anybody who's who's in the theater. Uh-huh. Or theater enthusiasts.
If there's anybody out there who deserves to be offended, it's those people.
But as far as in performance art, something that I can't stand, I hate so much, is, and I can't really probably convey it verbally, but you probably know what I'm talking about. The main character is singing their song. You've got the backup dancers, right? Uh-huh. You've got those moments where they're all kind of semicircled around, you know, behind the lead characters.
Yeah.
And they're staring at and overselling the facial expressions, reacting to everything that the person says. I can't really explain it, but
I know what you mean, though.
Oh, do I hate that. I hate that aspect of theatrical performance.
It is the worst.
It's so tired and it's so dumb looking and it's insulting. I hate it. I don't know what else. And this song brings all that up for some reason. So I couldn't stand this song.
What was your vote again?
Terrible idea. I don't know. Oh, okay. Use context clues, perhaps.
Okay. Chris, you want to vote next?
Yeah, hell.
Oh, let me find the clip.
This surpassed Boomerang in a race to the bottom. This is the worst of all time. The worst song in the entire Kiss catalog for me, and it's not even close.
It's hard to disagree with that.
Terrible.
As terrible as Boomerang is, it's really hard to say it's not better than this.
I think we can at least, we probably agree on that, but we can definitely agree that it's the worst cut on The Elder.
Oh, yeah.
Has to be, right?
Yeah, but not by a mile. You know what I mean? Like, they're ones that come close.
I don't know. I don't remember having this visceral negative opinion of the other songs. It was just kind of like, okay, this sucks, but it wasn't like just astonishingly bad like this one.
Yeah, this might be the worst of all time.
Hard to argue that.
Yeah, it's hard to say something's worse than it. I mean, I know the other thing that comes to mind, the other episode, was Chris's reaction to When You Wish Upon a Star.
Yeah.
Well, you reacted violently on the negative to it Never Goes Away.
Yeah.
Isn't that the one from Carnival of Souls?
Yeah, hated that one.
That angered you. Yeah. That was one of the handful of times where Nick was pissed off by a Kiss song.
This would be another one.
Wow.
Andy?
Hell. You know, guys.
What can you say about that hasn't been said before?
Same vocal style.
Yeah,
but that was way better.
No question.
That has to be the worst song we've ever listened to in 289 episodes. I can't imagine anything being worse than that. Boomerang kicks ass compared to that song.
You're probably right.
It's so bad. There's nothing good.
No.
No. No. Toward the end, we were trying to find something to latch on to, and it just wasn't happening.
Not even the child in a sundress could save that song. That was so bad.
Child in a sundress.
I don't have anything
good. Retard in boys' room.
You know, it's...
What if he ever did this song?
You know, whatever happened to that guy?
He's still out there. I hope so, anyway. The world is a better place with him in it.
I think it's kind of sad that we were able to get, through other people, contact with three members, original members of KISS, but we never got the retard in boys' room karaoke singer from YouTube.
Man.
Contribute anything.
His version of Easy As It Seems is just one of the greatest things on the entire internet.
Yeah.
You got a 7-year-old kid making millions doing toy reviews, yet retard boys' room languishes in obscurity.
Yeah, it's unfair.
It really is. It's a tragedy.
Life is unfair. Well, guys...
Well, you got to rubber stamp it.
Yeah. If you disagree, you don't.
No, well, somebody
you
will.
Don't.
That's just the fucking way it is.
No, that's...
There's one person in particular that I know will have a hot take on this.
There's no defense of this.
No. Give None. It a minute. He'll come up with something.
There's no valid, convincing
defense. He'll tie it into his idol, Jim Steinman, and make some sort of connection there. It ain't there, trust me.
Mm-hmm. Well, guys, let's hurry up. It's late.
Sing away.
Yes, Chief.
Nick overslept, we're cranky, and we get Odyssey. Perfect.
That's right, guys.
Wow, that song really tried me.
Yeah,
really
too,
tried.
I just zoned out.
Tried my patience.
Yeah, like you should have stayed asleep.
Yeah,
came all the way out here for this.
That's BS. All right, well, guys, it's time for a Yardo questions. Now, how lucky am I that I go to look at the Yardo questions folder on my phone? And it says, wait, let me tell you the exact thing. Storage almost full. It won't let me look at it.
Get out of here, really?
So I'm going to the internet here. Too much shit on there. Okay.
My storage is perpetually full.
It's the worst.
Delete a bunch of stuff, it fills up again immediately.
Is it photos or apps or a combination
it's
of the two?
Yeah.
It's both. Mine's both.
It just destroys.
Genital selfies.
Panoramic genital selfies.
Yeah. All right. Did we do this one? Yeah, we did.
Delete it. Too much text on that one. I can see it from here. That one looks reasonable.
This is perfect.
Okay.
All right.
Good.
This week's Yardo Questions comes to us from, oh, another great name, Frida Slaves. Did we do this one?
We've done something from this individual before.
I don't remember this individual.
Well, I don't
remember the name.
I do too, but I don't remember the question, so I think we're okay.
All right.
So, Frida Slaves, question one.
Could be a real name.
Could be.
Frida Slaves. Latina.
If there's something, if this sounds familiar, just tell me and we'll stop. Eric Singer has one of the worst asses in Kiss.
Yeah.
We did this?
I think so.
Oh, we did.
Who has the best or something like
no,
that?
No, and it said, and according to that dick length website, a small dick, what redeeming qualities does he have non-musically?
This sounds familiar.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Son of a bitch. I don't want to read one of these long
Why
ones.
Why haven't you deleted the ones we've done already?
I thought I did. I don't know.
He's working on a bound volume.
All right, here we go. This week's Yard of Questions comes to us from Harry Seaward. Get it?
I get it.
Barely.
All right, I don't think we did
Good
this one.
Good one.
Question one. Chris already answered my first question regarding his preference for the smell of fecal matter over the odor of urine. So let's just skip to question two.
And he's always talking about that, by the way.
Who yep. is?
You. I don't know. I don't remember this discussion.
You weren't on that show.
Yeah, that That's was the one with Jericho.
I guess you didn't go back and
Man,
listen.
What kind of weird stuff are you guys talking about?
When you're not around, all bets are off.
When has it not been weird when Jericho's been involved? It's part of the appeal.
That's true. Question two, based on the superiority of their first six...
Wait, Nick never answered that question, so let's pose the question okay. to him now.
What's your preference?
The smell of piss or the smell of shit? Which is worse?
Fecal matter.
Okay,
yeah,
fecal matter is worse.
Yeah, I don't know, man. Some pisses are just make you vomit immediately.
And yeah, but my criteria there, if you go into a bathroom and it smells like one or the other, and then you're at the urinal, you know, for like a minute, mm-hmm. and you're breathing it in,
oh.
which upsets you more? The fact that I'm getting this it's in my body right now.
Yeah.
It's the number two.
That happens every time I go into the bathroom at work. There must be low water level in the toilet or something.
So you just hit with it when you can't walk in? It's
horrible turd. If there's someone in the
stall. In the toilet or no, just the smell of it?
You can smell it. Like usually I think it's quickly underwater and the smell isn't dominant.
Well,
I don't know what's going on in there, but it's horrific.
Now, do you vocalize your disdain? Or
no, but I'm
going to
start tomorrow.
Ah! Yeah.
There's a...
God!
Where I work, it's like when you hover over the sink, there's a horrible smell.
Oh, Jesus. See,
something
that's...
in the plumbing.
That takes you by surprise.
Yeah, that's not good.
All right. Question two. Based on the superiority of their first six albums, what do you make of the fact that the band's output got shittier the more they came to rely on people outside of the four original members to write songs with or for them?
What a perfect episode for that to be a question.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. What do you make of it?
I mean, we had Is That You, which I think all three of us will agree is a great one.
I agree.
This was awful, but, Creatures of the Night had a lot of co-writes from people who weren't in the band.
Yeah.
And, you know... my opinion and the opinion of, I think, a decent amount of people, that's their best album.
Ooh. Well, let's not get ridiculous.
I'm not saying everybody, but I'm sure there are, you know, there is a mass of people who would agree with me.
Mm. Well, I just think it's a byproduct of when you've got a constantly revolving lineup, when you've got constant input from outside collaborators. You just, there's no, the cohesion and the chemistry just goes out the window.
And do you think it would have anything to do with once you've reached a certain level of notoriety and fame and whatever, prominence, that there's that pressure for quality material and you just feel like, what if I,
you know, what if I open the door to a few trusted collaborators here?
Yeah.
Then, you know, that's...
And that's... even that is simply ego-driven, and then once that happens, you got big problems. So...
All right, well...
It's a mixed bag.
Yeah.
But, well, I mean, even on the first six albums...
Yeah, there's misfires. Yeah,
and you had some... You had some co-writes.
Sure.
People who weren't in the band, so...
And it's not like they would have sustained that level of quality had everything been hunky-dory. I mean, nobody is completely awesome for every step of their career. They take chances, they do things that don't work out, like the Elder, and, you know, it's just, it's gonna happen the longer you're together.
I guess it's unavoidable, huh? All right, question three. In 1976, my fifth grade biology teacher told our class that Gene had the lingual frenulum under his tongue severed to make it stick out as far as it does. Do you think that's true?
I wonder if this is the same person who was my third grade teacher.
Wow.
Who told me she hung out in California with her girlfriend named Betty.
Oh, God.
Who was Beth from the song Beth. And
we know that's a lie.
And Gene Simmons happened to be hanging out there.
Oh, that's nice. How convenient.
Which I find out later, there's no Beth.
This woman's a complete liar.
Yeah, my teacher wasn't.
That's what you want from a teacher.
This is maybe the same. I might have had the same teacher as this guy.
How can your teacher reach her? Too busy in the hallway. do you think that's true? And then in parentheses, I now have a master's degree in computer science. Like Ace, I too am fascinated by technologies.
Well, let's hope that you put your music to your computer animations quicker than Ace has. Because he's been talking about it for decades. And we haven't seen a thing.
We haven't seen anything since ever. But, it was what? Psycho Circus era?
Though that's one of the more fun, tangents to go on when talking about Ace.
Yeah.
Is how he always talks about that. How he loves computers and he does computer animation. Which...
He does nothing.
I can't even make a meme.
I wonder if he could.
I doubt it.
If you said, Ace, I need you to make a meme. You've got 20 minutes.
Yeah, exactly.
He'd be like, I'm not from this planet. You know.
Yeah.
All the excuses would come pouring out. Anyway, do I think it's true? I don't know. It could be. I never really thought about it.
I've heard that.
How much extra length would you even get if you cut your frenulum?
I've heard that, and I heard it's not true.
Yeah, I think he said it's not true.
It's
but
probably not true. Why would you do that?
I think it's just a thing. Some people can do that. People have.
How much length would you get? Maybe a quarter of an inch.
Right.
It's not even worth it.
He's just got a big ass tongue.
Yeah. So I'm gonna say it's not true. That's my hunch.
So tell your fifth grade biology teacher that was it a woman? I don't know if it said. He or she has no idea what they're talking about. More lies. So, thank you, Harry C-Word, for your Yardo questions. And if you, the listener, wants to submit the final Yardo questions, go to podofthunder.com, click that widget, and send away a one, a two, a three questions to make a Yardo question.
Right. I didn't do a sound clip for that. I said last week I was going to.
Ah!
I apologize to the nobody who remembered that and was hoping for something.
It's okay. You know, we were on Instagram Live before the show started, and all of those questions were better than... not insulting this Yardo questions, but a lot of the ones we were clicking through, skipping over.
Mm-hmm.
Just should have just kept some of those and answered them on the show. Oh, well.
Could do a live yard of questions, maybe.
Wow.
Next week.
Holy shit. We're going to try it. Great idea.
So So don't submit.
Don't. Oh, you can. We'll see. It might not work.
That's so true.
Send away.
We might need you as a backup.
Swing away, as they say.
Swing away.
Yep. So, guys.
Yes, Chief.
You know, before we go, we've got a yearly delivery.
Oh, that's right.
From jolly old Saint Nick himself.
Which we happen to be recording on the...
On the day.
On the feast day.
So
this one's for the Garlic Dragon, so I'll keep that.
Wow.
This one is for Mr. 219.
That's
what it says.
Wow, Saint Nick. Mr. 219 himself. What does it say? Is that all it says, though?
I don't know.
Read it.
It's dark in here, man.
Read that shit.
Saint Nick, part one, part two pending.
Ooh, that's...
Really?
That's a tease for the future.
That's good.
So mine's to Andy, America's little brother. Oh, guys.
Here we go.
Saint Nick.
Always comes
a
through.
A yard of socks here.
Saint Nick knows what I wanted.
I'm wearing these on Christmas.
Look at that. Yard of socks. Love it.
Anybody else get the cloud pattern?
Yeah, this one.
Yeah. I like that.
I did.
That's nice. Lovely.
Won't be needing these gift receipts.
Nope.
No.
It's going right in the garbage.
I'll wipe my butt with those.
Love these. Pair of thieves socks. These are excellent. The most fitting sock under the tree.
Good one.
The most fitting sock in all the land. It depends which one you're...
A limited edition holiday collection.
That's right. The gold one.
Did anybody else get anything from the obsidian collection?
I wish.
Well, would that be the most fitting sock under?
You don't wear it on your feet either. Do the math on that.
All right. Well, thank you to
the obsidian collection.
Thank you
great
to
stuff.
Saint Nick for the gift. Very much appreciated.
And there's another gift coming, apparently.
Pending.
For our last Kiss episode.
Yeah.
It's happening next week, the end of the load. Get ready for it.
It's coming. All right. It's late, huh? It's almost midnight.
Yeah, it's very late.
Holy shit. It's like a Jericho episode. Where's the pizza?
Yeah, no shit.
Yeah.
Let's get out of here.
Let's go home. I got to go to sleep.
Man.
I'll see you guys.
I'll go sleep again.